discuss the first one. Okay, calculate the current I5, IS and voltage V7 for the network shown. So this is a network. A given network is this. Say it's see all resistance. This is R1, R2, R3. So this is R4. So this one is R5. So it is R6. This one is R7. This is R8, and this one is R9. Even you have all the values with you. It is 4 kilo ohm, 8 kilo ohm. This is 12 kilo ohm, 24 kilo ohm. This is 12 kilo ohm, and this E value is 72 volts. Then so this is 9 kilo ohm. This R8 is 3 kilo ohm, and R9 is right. So let us see solution of this. What you were supposed to do, you were supposed to calculate the currents. Which currents? I5 you calculate. So this is the I5 which is shown in the network. This is IS, and voltage you were supposed to calculate, that is V7. Which is across R7. So you were supposed to calculate V7, say, which is across R7. Say how to proceed. Very simple thing. Look at dear students. This side of the network is very simple to simplify, because R1, R2, R3 all are in series. I simply write like this. Look at this. I'll do like this. Let RA is equal to some resistance. RA is equal to series combination of R1 plus R2 plus R3. So because all are in series, R1, R2, R3, all are in series, which is equal to, say, look at this, 8 plus 12 is 20, and this is 24 kilo ohm. Very simple. And when all three resistors are replaced by only one resistance, which is RA, that resistance will be in parallel with R4. So because of that, let RB is equal to RA parallel with R4. Very simple. RA is 24 kilo ohm. Even R4 is also 24 kilo ohm. So when two resistors of equal value are in parallel, the equivalent resistance will be half of that, which is equal to 12 kilo ohm. Very simple. Then when all these four resistors can be replaced by RB, and that RB will be in series with R5, that combination I call it as RC. Let RC is equal to RB plus R5. RB value is already known to me, 12 kilo ohm, plus R5 is also 12 kilo ohm, which is equal to 24 kilo ohm. Means this total left side of the network, say this, if you take this voltage source, left side of this, I can replace total by only one resistance, that is RC. Okay, so if I say keeping EA at the center, if I draw the reduced network, here I'll get RC, and parallel with that, you have E, which is a voltage source whose value is 72 volts, and remaining things I'll draw as it is, right? So, and what is this? So this one is R6. Now, very simple, dear students. If you see this particular network, look at this. Here, the voltage across RC is E, because both are in parallel. RC and E both are in parallel. The voltage across RC is E. And this, whatever I5 is there, say I5 is a current through R5. And because R5 and RB both are in series, the current through series combination, RB and R5 will be I5 only. That means this is I5. RC is a series combination of RB and R5. In a series, there will be same current. That means through RB and R5, there is the same current, that is I5. And I5 is the current through RC, means I can easily find I5 is equal to, say it is equal to E, because across RC the voltage is E, divided by the resistance is RC, just using Ohm's law here. And this is equal to 72 volts divided by RC is 24 kilo ohm. If you calculate 74 by 24 is 3 milliampere. So now, after finding I5, so what I do, I'm going to reduce right side of this network, because R8, R9 both are in series. You can see R8 and R9 both are in series. I'll write here, let some resistance RD is equal to R8 plus R9. So R8 is, how much is the value of R8? This is 3 kilo ohm, and R9 is 6 kilo ohm, which is equal to 9 kilo ohm. Okay, and select, say this RD, if you see these two resistors, if I replace by RD, that RD will be in parallel with R7. So that parallel combination I call it as RE. Select RE is equal to RD parallel R7, because dear students, I'm going to replace these two resistors by one resistance, that is RD, and that resistance will be in parallel with R7. Okay, then R7 and RD both are in parallel. RE is equal to, this is equal to, RD is 9 kilo ohm, R7 is also 9 kilo ohm, obviously RE will be 4.5 kilo ohm, half of that. Now, when I replace all three resistors by a single resistance, that is RE, that resistance will come in series with R6. And that series combination, let me call it as RF. RF will be, RE plus of R6, both are in series. And one is, R6 is 12 kilo ohm. Okay, so another one is 4.5 kilo ohm, which is equal to 16.5 kilo ohm is your RF, right? So now, it is very simple to solve. If I redraw this particular network by changing all this, means by replacing resistors R6, R7, R8, R9 by a single resistance RF, what we get? Here you have RC parallel with this E, and parallel with this you have RF. This is RF, this is RC, this is E. E value is 72, right? And remember, dear students, this is IS. Say this current is IS. Okay. So now IS can be easily found. Say before that, if at all you want RT, the total network of this, the total resistance of this network, that if I replace it by RT, okay, from this figure, RT is equal to, means RT is what? The total network. That you should properly write in words. Okay. The total network of the, say the total resistance of the network is given by RT is equal to RC parallel RF. Okay. So where, say one is 24 kilo ohm and another one is parallel is 16.5 kilo ohm. Say if you calculate it, 24 into 16.5 divided by 24 plus of 16.5 is equal to, yes, it is 9.7778 kilo ohm is your total resistance RT. Now, what is IS? IS is equal to E by RT. Very simple. The total resistance is RT. So the current IS is, say, Ohm's law once again, E by RT, which is equal to E is 72 divided by RT is 9.7778 kilo ohm. Say, which you get, say, IS is equal to, yes, how much you get? Say, if you calculate this, 72 divided by answer is equal to, it is 7.3636. Say, IS is equal to 7.3636 milliampere. Second one. So you found I5, you found IS, and now thing is, you were supposed to find V7. So V7 is very simple. If you see, V7 is the current voltage across resistance R7. Already I know I7, there are so many methods to find V7. Because if you see, these two resistors are in parallel, that combination is in parallel with R7. Okay. And here you have 72. Like say, for example, say if you see this, it is something like this. Okay, so here you have R6. Okay. So here you have R7, right? And these two resistors, if I replace it to a single resistance, okay, say R8 and R9, say that I have represented as RD. Like say, if you see this RD, this R7 and this R6, this is your E. Say between parallel, there will be same voltage. Whatever the voltage V7 is there across R7, the same voltage will be there across RD. That means I can use a simple voltage division rule to calculate, say, voltage across R7. Say that is V7 is equal to, main voltage is V into resistance of the branch. These parallel branches I should consider. Okay. So one is R7 and another one is RD. Say R7 is how much? Say that is R7 is here. Say it is 9 kilo ohm. Even RD is also 9 kilo ohm. That means it is, say, parallel combination will be 4.5 kilo ohm, say divided by 4.5k plus of, say, another resistance is R6. If you substitute the value, say E is 72, say for example, so I'll calculate, it is E is 72 into, say, R7, 4.5 divided by 4.5 plus of R6. R6 value is 12. So how much you get? This is equal to 19.636, right? Second one is this. Okay, so this is a determine values of below parameters, that means voltages and currents. What I do, so I don't copy it, I'll start here itself. Okay, so this is the question. Okay, so determine values of below parameters for the network shown in figure. Okay, so this you are supposed to find determine V2, V3, V4, V5, I1, I2, I3, I4, I5. This is once again very simple than the previous. Okay, only thing here you have two dependent sources. One is current source, another one is voltage source. This 10 ohm is in parallel with V1, yes or not? Okay, so 10 ohm is parallel with V1. Obviously, the voltage across 10 ohm is V2. V2 is equal to V1 is equal to 2 volts. Okay, now current I2. I2 is what? It's a current through 10 ohm resistor. Ohm's law, very simple. V2 by resistance is 10 ohm, which is equal to 2 volts divided by, say, how much is that? 2 volts divided by 10 ohm, which is equal to 0.2 ampere. Otherwise, you can write it as a 200 milliampere. Okay. Then I3 is equal to, what is I3? Look at this. This is a current I3. What is this I3? I3 is equal to, it is 5 times V2. Already I know V2. 5 into 2 is equal to 10 ampere. So means I3 is, see, I2 is 200 milliampere, or say 0.2 ampere you found, and I3 is equal to 10 ampere you found it, right? So now what you can find, look at this. So you can find, you have found, say this, you can find V4 easily because you have already found I2. V4 can be found easily. Okay, so how much is V4? V4 is equal to 5 times I2. Okay, 5 into, say, so I2 is how much? 0.2 ampere, which is equal to, say, this implies your V4 is equal to 1 volt. Very simple. Okay, say, so after V4, see, you found V4, and look at this. V4 and V5 both are in parallel. Obviously, in parallel, there will be same voltage. Okay, say, so V5 is equal to, V4 is equal to 1 volt. Say, so after this, what you are supposed to find? I5 you are supposed to find. Say, so is there anything to tell I5? How can you find? It is voltage divided by resistance. Voltage is V5 divided by resistance is 5 ohm. Okay, so which is equal to 1 volt divided by 5 ohm is equal to, say, 0.2 ampere, or say I5 is equal to 200 milliampere, or say 0.2 ampere. You can find V3 also. See here, say V3, how can you find? The V3 can be easily found. So look at this. The voltage across 10 ohm resistor is V2. Here, parallelly, there will be same voltage here and here. Between these two branches, there will be same voltage because both are in parallel. Means if I consider this as a one branch where I do have a some voltage, and here one voltage, and this is one loop, I can consider this as a only one loop. Considering this as one branch and parallelly, there will be same voltage. Some voltage V2 is there. Here, if I consider some voltage V1, means some voltage VA, some voltage VB. This is main voltage now. V2 will be divided between these two. Has got some VA voltage. This branch has got some VB voltage. That means V2 is equal to VA plus VB. Using that concept, we'll do this. Okay. So what you we can write? So we can write V3 is equal to. So if you see V3, say that is otherwise, even I write using V2. So V2 is equal to, V2 is this main voltage, and this voltage plus this voltage. Even you can apply KVL also for this. Okay. So if you apply KVL, -2+, I'll take it as V2. Then +2 -V3. Okay. +2 -V4. Around the loop, all the voltages will be zero. Right. And say what you want from this, you want V3 is equal to V2 -V4. V2 already known to you, how much is V2? It is 2 volts. V4 is already known to you, it is 1 volt. Say V3 is equal to 1 volt, right? Two more you are supposed to find. Say two more means one is I4 and another one is I1. Okay, very simple. These are currents. To find the currents, say we use here KCL. Okay. If you use KCL here, look at this. This is a node, some node. You consider this as node A, node B, anywhere. Say node, say you can name this node as anything. This is current, that is I3 incoming, and two currents are outgoing. Applying KCL at, say, for example, node A or say node B, you can name and properly write it. Okay. So I3 can be given as I3 is incoming is equal to, two currents are outgoing, I5 and I4, I4 plus I5. Sum of incoming currents is equal to sum of outgoing current, KCL. Okay, so from this, what actually we require? I4 is equal to I3 minus I5. So I know I3. I3 value is how much? 10 ampere minus I5 is how much? 0.2 ampere. So which is equal to I4 is equal to 9.8 ampere, right? And lastly, we're supposed to find I1, and that I1 is, say, main current. So this is the main current. Once again, I use here KCL. If I apply a KCL at this node, incoming current is equal to two outgoing currents. One incoming current is there, I1. Two outgoing currents are I2 and I3. Okay. I1 is equal to I2 plus I3. I2 is how much? I2 is 0.2 ampere plus I3 is a 10 ampere. So therefore, I1 is equal to 10.2 ampere. So now next one is this third one here itself. So this is actually easier than first two. So what you were supposed to find? You were supposed to determine the voltage V and current I for the network shown in figure 3, and also calculate the power dissipated. One thing, dear students, if there is, what is resistance opposition for the flow of current? If no current will flow through that, no opposition, nothing but no resistance. Keep this in mind. Okay, because resistance itself is a opposition for the flow of current. When there is no current, there is no opposition. When there is no opposition, there is no resistance. Because this is open, R5 is open, no current will flow through R5. It's as good as the resistance R5, which is 8 ohm, doesn't come into picture. Because resistance will come into picture only when current will pass through that. Now, coming to this, the R1 is short circuited. Okay, it's a simple thing. No current will flow through R1. Even though it is connected, no current will flow through R1. Why, sir? Why? Because the current always finds the least resistance path. Even though there is one path, it doesn't flow through this because there is no resistance here. Zero resistance, zero opposition. Obviously, the whole current, whatever is coming from 30 volts, that current will flow through I. Means I is the current supplied by this 30 volt source. No current will flow through R1. This is one concept. In parallel, you can calculate the resistance. The resistance of this branch is zero. The resistance of this branch is 6 ohm. 0 into 6 divided by 0 plus 6 is equal to 0. That means the combination, if I replace these two, the resistance will be 0. Very simple thing. That means this will not be there. Say only thing here, short circuit. Only these two concepts are enough for solving this. So let me solve this. If you see, this resistance will not be there. I'll find R to find current I, I'll find RT. Okay. Say these two are in parallel because this resistance is not there. These two resistors are in parallel. 8 ohm, both are in parallel. That means equivalent is 4 ohm. 4 ohm plus 6 ohm is 10 ohm. RT is equal to 10 ohm. Okay. So now, so after that, so you can find easily I. I is equal to, it is, I is current through this. The total resistance at this point is RT, 10 ohm. Because this resistance don't have any effect, doesn't have any effect. Here, these two resistors are in parallel, 8 ohm, 4 ohm plus this 6 ohm, it is 10 ohm. And I is equal to 30 volts divided by RT. And 30 volts divided by RT is how much? It is 10 ohm is equal to 3 ampere. I is equal to 3 ampere. Very simple. Okay. And voltage V, so which you are supposed to find across this. Okay. No current will flow through this because it is open. Obviously, there is no drop here. Across R5, there will not be any drop. No current means no drop. Because current, say voltage is equal to, say, resistance into current, no current. Right? So obviously, say there is no drop here, means the V is directly across R4 and R5. You can consider here zero. That means V is directly across R3 and R4. So how can you find? So if I say find the these two, if I consider it as one resistor whose value is 4 ohm, here there is no resistor. This 30 volts will divide between this 4 ohm and this 6 ohm. Very simple. I hope this is clear to you. This is 0. This is doesn't come into picture, as good as 0. These two are in parallel, 4 ohm. This is 6 ohm. So what you can do? So you can find V is equal to 30 volts into 4 ohm using voltage division rule divided by 4 ohm plus 6 ohm is equal to 120 divided by 10, and V is equal to 12 volts. Then one more, what you were supposed to find is power dissipated by R4. Power dissipated by R4, which I represented by V4, is equal to, say what you can do, across R4 you know the voltage, because across this 12 volts means here also you will get 12 volts. Between parallel combination, there will be 12 volts only. Here 12 volts means here it will be 12 volts only. Okay, so because of that, I use this V square by R. Okay, say V is 12 square divided by R is 8 ohm. And P is equal to, says, if you calculate it, it is 12 square divided by 8 is equal to, how much is that? 18 watts is your power dissipated by resistor R4. So then the next one I do, okay? So this is very simple one. So this is given voltmeter reading, V is equal to 27 volts in figure 5. Is the network operating properly? Explained. Means whether this network is operating, functioning properly, you should explain. Second one is, if it is not working properly, what could be the cause for incorrect reading? First and foremost, it is showing 27 volts. We should calculate whether it should show 27 volts or not. Then only we can tell that this network is functioning properly. Theoretically, if we get voltage across R3 or R4, which is equal to 27 volts, then we can say that this network is functioning properly. If we don't get voltage across R3 or R4, which is equal to 27 volts, then obviously we can tell that it is not working properly, it's not functioning properly. Is network operating properly? Whether the voltage across R3 is 27 volts or not, that's the meaning. Okay, so now say very simple, we'll start this. Say here, if you see, say, first and foremost, our intention should be to find the voltage across R3. So how do I find? So look at this. These two resistors are in parallel. 12 into 6 divided by 12 plus 6. How much you get? 12 into 6 divided by 18 is equal to, okay. So this 4 kilo ohm resistor is in parallel with the 36. Okay. So you find the, say, the parallel combination. Say it is 4 into 36 divided by 40. How much you got? It is 3.6. okay, means all three, R2, R3, R4, all three resistors can be replaced by only one resistance whose value is 3.6 kilo ohm. Hope it is clear to you. If we reduce this network, so you will get something like this. This is 45 volts, this is 6 kilo ohm, and here all three resistors can be replaced by only one resistance, which you may call it as R5. Say it is equal to R2 parallel, R3 parallel, R4, and you got this parallel combination equal to 3.6 kilo ohm. Very simple. And this already you know it is 6 kilo ohm. Okay. So now how can you find our voltage across this? Using voltage division rule. And one more, dear students, keep this in mind. Because R2, R3, R4 all are in parallel, the voltage across R2, R3, R4 will be same. Because parallel there will be same voltage, which already we know. Okay, so now say applying voltage division rule, say voltage V, which is across R3, will be same voltage across R4, will be same voltage across R2. That means across RA, the voltage is V. V is equal to main voltage is E into resistance of the branches RA divided by sum of the resistors RA plus 6 kilo, right? So if you substitute V is equal to, say it is 45 volts into 3.6 kilo ohm divided by 3.6 kilo ohm plus of 6 kilo ohm. Say solve it. This is 45 into 3.6 divided by, say, 3.6 plus 6 is equal to, say, how much is this? 16.875 volts is V. That means R, actually, if you connect some voltmeter here, it should show 16.875. It is showing 27 volts, means this particular old network is not working properly. Why it is not working? Some of the devices, means elements, might have not been connected properly. That we should analyze. Okay, one thing, dear students, here you are getting some voltage, means Obviously, the current is flowing through this 6 kilo. Because when the current is flowing, then only you will get some voltage. He is telling that you are getting, it is showing some voltage. Okay, that means a 6 ohm, this R1 is connected properly. If R1 is not connected, let us consider R1 is not connected, no current will flow through this. This voltmeter cannot show any reading, right? So this is working properly. And coming to this, okay, means say here these three resistors are in parallel. One of the resistor might not connected properly. Because of that, actually you should get 16.875, but you are getting 27 volts more than the actual value. More than the actual value, when you get, see, voltage is, look at this. The voltage is going to divide between RA, and telling that the voltage across RA is 27, but actual voltage across RA is 16.875. That means voltage across RA is more, nothing but RA value is more. When RA value can be more between parallel, whenever say more resistors are there, the resistance will be lesser. Remember one thing, dear students, in a parallel combination, the equivalent resistance will be less than the lesser one. This is a very basic concept. Between parallel, many parallel resistors are there. Let us consider, say, for example, this is 4 kilo, this is 12 kilo. I don't know this resistance, sir. It has got some value, but more than 12 kilo, if you say, then I'll tell that, say, the parallel equivalent resistance of this will be lesser than 4 kilo. Surely it will be lesser than 4 kilo. Because the inner parallel resistance, the say, equivalent resistance will be less than the lesser one. This is a very basic concept. This is very basic concept. Parallelly, because see, in a series, the total resistance will be more than the highest resistance, because they'll add up. Here there will be a division. Okay. Anyhow, say, if you know that simple concept of resistor, say, we'll understand that, say, here, whatever the RA we are getting, 3.6 kilo ohm, this may not be 3.6 kilo ohm, this might be more than that. That's what, when we multiply RA and V, we are getting 27. We should get some more than this. Okay, so let us consider one by one. If you don't know, also let us consider. If I consider that 36 kilo ohm is not connected properly, let me consider 36 kilo ohm is not connected properly. Means if it is not connected properly, then whatever the voltage is there, it will divide between only these two. Means 12 into 6 divided by, say, 18, it's nothing but 4. 4, say, if you see, say, you can calculate, say, V is equal to E into, say, 4 divided by 4 plus 6. Okay, say, E is how much? 45. 45 into 4 divided by 10 is equal to how much you got? It is 18 volts. That means this is also no. R2 is connected properly. If I consider, say, for example, 12 kilo ohm is not connected properly, okay, then only these two resistors will be there. Then you can find the parallel combination. 36 into 6 divided by 42, say, is equal to, you will get around 5.17. And into, say, how much? 45 divided by answer plus, say, another is a 6 kilo ohm. Say, is equal to, you will get around 20. Means if this 12 kilo ohm resistance is not connected properly, you will get 20 volts. If 36 kilo ohm is not connected properly, you are getting around 18 volts. Now, if I consider 6 kilo ohm, what you get? Okay, so let us consider that 6 kilo ohm is not connected properly. Obviously, the total resistance, which I call it as a new resistance RA dash, the parallel combination of 36 kilo ohm and say 12 kilo ohm. Because 6 kilo ohm, this time I'll consider 6 kilo ohm is not connected properly. So obviously it is 36 into 12 divided by, say, 48, say, is equal to 9 kilo ohm. R dash will be 9 kilo ohm. And now, if at all I want the voltage across this, V is equal to, okay, so this is main voltage is E into R dash, RA dash divided by, say, RA dash plus of, say, another one is what? Another is R1, which is nothing but 6 kilo ohm here, right? So this is equal to, so if you substitute 45 into, so R dash is how much? It is 9 kilo divided by 6 plus 9K, 6K plus 9K. Okay, so this is 45 into 9 divided by 15 is equal to how much is this? 27 volts. V is equal to 27 volts. He is telling that V is 27 volts. Obviously, the resistor 6 kilo ohm is not connected properly, the reason, the cause for this wrong reading. So because the reading, the actual reading you should get is 16.875, but you are getting 27 volts. The cause is this 6 kilo ohm is not connected properly. I'm telling one thing, sir, why you are, how you are telling, dear students, this 6 kilo ohm is, if it's not connected, no current will flow through this. And you cannot think that 6 kilo ohm is not connected properly. Only thing is, between these three, one of the resistor is not connected properly. Which is that resistor? Okay. Say, already the combination is 3.6 kilo ohm. This combination is going to increase. Then only you will get the voltage more than 16.87. Then when the parallel combination will increase, when the resistors there is going to say change. Finally, you should tell that say because the resistance 6 kilo ohm is not connected properly, say right in bracket, say it is open circuit. That's the reason the total resistance will reduce to a 9 kilo ohm. So because of that, say the voltmeter is showing the wrong reading. Because you got 27 volts neglecting this 6 kilo ohm.